Jesus. I'm glad. You know, he said, you didn't choose me, I chose you. And he's glad that Jesus chose you. You know, Paul said we were chosen before the foundation of the world. We were chosen in Christ. We were chosen in Christ before the foundation of the world. You know, Jeremiah didn't want to be no prophet. He didn't want to prophesy. He said, I'm a child. And the Lord said, say not I'm a child, Jeremiah. He said, before you was formed in the womb, I knew you. Before you came out of the womb, I sanctified you. I ordained you to be a prophet. To pan out, to root up, to replant, to rebuild. So when Jeremiah come to knowledge, he was already called and chosen. He just woke up in one day and realized he couldn't get away from it. It wasn't his choice. God done made his choice. He said, Jeremiah, I knew you.
Yes, he did.
Before you was even in your mama's womb. Yes. You telling me you can't do what I told you to do? Yes. Until I sanctified you before you came out.
Go ahead.
I ordained you. Be a prophet to the nation. He said to tear down false religion, tear down false gods, root it up from the roots. Don't just cut it down, root it up. Because if you just cut it down, it may sprout back up. God said, I don't want it to sprout back up. I want you to root it up. God tears something down. He takes it down for good. He don't mean for it to sprout. And those when he takes the devil down and Antichrist down, when he takes his old wicked world down, it ain't ever going to sprout up. He said in the 4th chapter of Malachi, he said the time will come, you're burnt, it'll burn like an oven. Yea, the wicked shall be burned up to ashes. And there shall be ashes on the soles of your feet, said the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But he said unto those that fear my name, it's a different story. See, the wicked's going to be punished if they don't come to Jesus. The only hope is Jesus. He told Nicodemus, you must be born again. Or you won't even see the kingdom of heaven. He said, the time will come, shall burn like an oven, and the wicked shall be ashes on the soles of your feet. But unto you that fear my name, shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings. You shall grow up, he said. While the wicked is being brought down, you're going to grow up like stall-fed calves, if you know what a stall-fed calf is. I mean, you're fattening him up.
Hey, come on, preacher.
You're fattening him up. Stone fed. I said, you're going to be like a stone fed cat.
Glory.
I'm going to make you fat in me. I'm going to make you strong in the Lord. Daniel said, them that know their God. I'm telling you, something in store for the righteous. But also something in store for the wicked.
Go ahead.
There are two sides of this. You know, we're living in an hour that everybody's going to heaven. But that ain't the Bible.
Come on.
Everybody ain't going to heaven. You must be born again. Jesus said, I'm the way, sides. Most preachers today just preaching one side.
Go ahead.
And you know, you got a coin, you got heads and tails.
Yes, you do.
There's another side to God. It is written in the Bible. I said, there's another side to God. That same Jesus. He's got the nail scars in his hands that hung on the cross. Bled and died for your sins. One day he'll be the judge. And that same hand is bound in scars that bled and died for you. Will point at you. And say, depart from me, you work of iniquity. I never knew you. I want you to know something. There's something in store for the righteous, but there's also something in store for this wicked generation.
Jesus.
He told Isaiah 58, said, cry out and spare not. He said, lift up your voice like a trumpet. Show my people their transgressions. See, that's what a preacher's supposed to do. Correct. Point out the error. That's what the prophets of old did. When Israel would go astray, he would raise up a man of God, a sinner. That's what Elijah did. He would point out the sins. He said in 2 Corinthians, it's my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face. Then when I hear from heaven, I forgive the sins.
That's right.
And I'll heal the land.
Glory!
But we live in a society, that's why sin's footloose.
That's right.
That's why homosexuality is footloose in the church.
Yes, sir. Go ahead, Brother Reed. Go ahead.
Jesus. So, well, you know, that's just the way they are. We live in a nation that's passed a law that two men that get married get a marriage license.
Go ahead.
Two women that get married. It ain't all right. The Bible said it's abomination.
Yes, it is.
Come on.
Yes, it is.
Hallelujah.
He says, man don't put a lie with man, and man ain't put a lie with beast in the same place. Shows you what category he put it in.
Jesus.
It's abomination. Both. Abomination.
Go ahead.
Go ahead, preacher.
I want you to know you got everything going on in Hollywood. They're training dogs. Beast. Abomination.
Yes, sir.
We're living in the wicked age.
Yes, sir.
Child molesters. Men going like, crawling like snakes looking for some child somewhere. And now they're turning men loose to go into women's bathrooms in this country. It's an abomination. There ain't no man wants no man to go in the bathroom with his wife, children. This is just the time we're living in. It's going to have to transgender my foot. It's an abomination. We need a revival in this country. We need to turn it back to God. We need a great awakening. We need an outpouring of the Holy Ghost and turn us back to God. You can only turn sin foot loose for so long till God will come show up.
Yes, sir.
What he said, as it was in the days of Noah, as it was in the days of Lot, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the day of the coming of the Son of Man.
Yes, sir.
Men will be eating and drinking. You know where there's eating places, jam packed, folks waiting in line, circling buildings. Quiet, ain't you?
Go ahead!
That's why we said, for the coming of the Lord, that's the way it would be.
That's right.
We'd be eating and Men just jumping from one woman to the other, women jumping from one man to the other. No limit.
Go ahead.
Turn foot loose. As it was in the days of Lot. The Bible said they planted, they built, they bought. Right up to the same day, fire fell from heaven and burned them all up. This generation ain't going to get away with this kind of wickedness. Preachers are afraid to stand up.
Go ahead.
Preachers are afraid to declare the truth. They're afraid to cry out, spare not, lift their voice up like a trumpet.
Yes.
See, this stuff couldn't go on when every pulpit was sounding the alarm.
Go ahead.
These laws couldn't pass when the word of God would stand up across this country. But these meaty mouth macaroni backbone preachers is afraid of their job. It ain't no job, it's a calling. I said it ain't no living, it's a life. We're preaching for a living, we ought to go work for a living. It ain't about a living, it's about a life. It's about being called. Before you do, and you ain't got nothing to do with it.
That's right. Go ahead.
Like he called Jeremiah and sent him. He come to realize he was called to go and root up this stuff. Cry out against it. Stand up and save God's people from this stuff. You know, these demons just move in on people, and the preachers don't cry out against it and wake them up. And pulling the scales off their eyes, they'll go right on in to what the worlds are doing. They won't realize. Well, now, listen, if you have your Bible, Jeremiah chapter 51. Jeremiah 51. Verse 44. And I will punish Baal in Babylon. I will bring forth out of his mouth that which he has swallowed up. And the nations shall not flow together anymore unto him. Yea, the wall of Babylon shall fall. My people, go ye out of the midst of her and deliver ye every man his soul from the fierce anger of the Lord. God, I thank you for your word. Pray with me. Lord, I thank you for your holy word. God, you're our battle axe. You're our life. You're our source. Save us. You said, I sent my word and it healed them. Lord, heal us, Lord. Apostle Paul said, we're washed with the washing of the water of the word. Deliver us, Lord, from this generation. God, people have fallen into a snare. Churches, preachers, throwing their hands up and going along with sin. Lord, help us to be like Paul. Lord, it stood up and is about to leave. He instructed Timothy what to do, to preach the word. God, help us to be one of those that will preach the word. God, not look for a way out. Not look for something easy. But Lord, to speak your word to this generation. God, this generation needs you. Her people are dying. Being lost. Lord, this whole world's going to hell. Wake us up, Lord. God, Babylon. You said there's fallen in the Lord, in the book of Revelation. Said, come out of and you won't partake of her plagues. Lord, save us. Save us, Lord. Give us your word. Oh, don't ever fail. There are few of us still want your word, Lord. God, there are few of us still want your truth. Lord, like those disciples said, Lord, forevermore, give us this bread. God, don't ever take your word away from us. Thank you, Lord. Let somebody say amen.
Amen.
You know, when the word of God was taken away from nations, no matter how strong the armies were, if God turns his back on the nation, no matter how strong, how many jets they got, it won't do you no good. God can take a little old nation, a little old nobody, and it comes down to it. You know, I remember back when Mike Tyson, all the news when he was whooping everybody, stood up and denounced Jesus. Went to Muslim religion. God told me, said he's won his last. That time he went down to nothing. No matter how strong you are, if you ain't serving God, you better not denounce him for a false God. Just better keep your mouth shut. Trying to get some kind of clout. He forgot who was in charge. He knows this is a generation that's forgot all these politicians in Washington. They forgot who's really in charge. And no matter how strong a nation is, if God turns his back on it, she'll fall. Israel was chosen of God. But when they begin to serve other gods and go after false gods, God will bring them down to make them pray. No matter how what your strength is, without God, can you make it? America needs God. Hear me? America needs a Holy Ghost revival.
Yes, Jesus. Yes, we do.
I believe it's coming.
Glory.
But it's coming to those that are hungry.
Yes, amen.
It's coming to those that want it more than they want the world.
Yes,
hallelujah. What you seek? He said, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and his righteousness. And all these other things would be added to you. It seems like people can't get to the point that they seek God and let God add to them what they need.
Go ahead, brother.
They got to seek things instead of God.
Amen.
And that's what America's done. America's turned her back on God. She's seeking things and not God. But no matter how strong the nation is, we better remember our roots. We better remember where we came from. We better remember when the old teachers used to read the Bible every morning. Pray. Say the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. Now it's against the law. They're burning the flag. Say, you can't read the Bible in schools. Against the law. Some has passed it. Thank God some of the states are standing up. I believe Mississippi did. Passing the laws back. But you know what? That low down federal government, they'll take away the money when you don't do what they say. But you tell you what, I believe a state of people will follow God. He can make it without the federal government. I believe you can make it with Jesus. I said, I believe we can make it. We don't have to be in battle.
Go ahead.
It's like independent churches, himself. Well, Jesus said, I'm alone, but yet I'm not alone. But the Father's with me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm telling you, when you preach the truth, when you cry loud and spare not, you'll find yourself walking along, and preachers will flee from you. You ain't got to change. Just keep on preaching like you've been preaching. Keep on preaching the truth. And if they don't love that truth, they'll start departing from you. But you know, all them preachers just departed. God's putting two back in their place. I see God raising up young preachers. I see God raising up all them that's just departed because I won't bend and bow. I won't go along with this system. I won't go along with Mr. Babylon. I won't go along with Jezebel. I won't go along with the great whore. False religion. You stand up and preach the word just like it was with Jesus. You know what they did? As long as he was multiplying the fish and the loaves, they want to make him a king in St. John 6. Who would want a king that could just multiply, take five loaves and two fish and multiply and feed 5,000 men beside the women and children with five loaves and two fish?
Hallelujah.
That's what they wanted him for. Because he could multiply the fish and the loaves. But Jesus stood up there in St. John 6. He said, I'm the bread.
Yes, he did.
I'm the bread.
Hallelujah.
That come down from heaven.
Yes.
See, they was just been dealing with multiplying the fish and loaves. And Jesus said, I'm that bread.
Yes.
They said, well, our fathers, Moses gave our fathers bread in the wilderness. And they eat. He said, yeah, they're dead too.
That's right.
He said, but if you eat this bread, you'll never die. I am the bread that come down from heaven. Since you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no life.
Hallelujah.
You know what there? I mean the disciples that was following him. You know what they said? How can this man give us his flesh? He says, my flesh is meat indeed, my blood is drinking. To keep my flesh and drink my blood, you have no life. And the Bible said the life is in the blood. Under the old covenant, your life is in your blood. You get cut. That's why you say, stop the blood. Stop it. You try to hold it. You try to grip it. You try to turn it. You do everything you do because you know you ain't going to be here long if you're bleeding. You bleed out, you'll die. The life is in the blood. That's why when they offer them animals and they cut their throat, they offer their life. That life is in the blood. And that's why they offer that blood, because that blood represented life. Life for life. Given a life for our life. Then Jesus hung on the cross. They beat him to a pulp. Nailed him to a tree. Stuck a sword up in his side. Blood and water gushed out. He offered his blood. He gave his blood. He gave his blood. And the life is in the blood. That's why we got eternal life. Jesus gave his life. His life was God. As I live with the Father, he said, if you eat me, you'll live by me. He gave his blood, which was his life. He gave his life for my life. He gave his life for my life.
Hallelujah.
why I have eternal life. That's why you got eternal life. Because Jesus shed his blood. And the life is in the blood. See, all the animals, Paul said the blood of animals, bulls and goats never did take away sin. It was just a type and a shadow of what was to come. Jesus. It was a schoolmaster to keep people pointed in the right direction. But it all pointed to the one day, once and for all, Jesus went into the Holy of Holies. Like the priest and offered up himself as a sacrifice. God accepted that blood for the atonement of the sin of the person. Hallelujah. I said he became our atonement. Because the life was in the blood. And as long as he was multiplying fish and loaves. That's what church is about for a lot of folks now, fish and loaves.
That's right.
You give them suppers and dinners and fish fries, they'll pack it out.
Yes,
you call a prayer meeting, you won't have enough to turn the lights on. I say it again, have a fish fry, a dinner, or chicken fry.
Yes, sir.
They'll show up from every hollow. But they ain't there for the word of God. They just like them folks that followed Jesus, they was there for the fish and loaves. Because when Jesus began to give them the word, they turned their back on him and walked away. That's what this generation is doing. But you know what? This generation is walking away from Jesus again, but I'm telling you, it didn't stop the kingdom then, and ain't going to stop it now. They folks waiting in the wings. There's the harlots and the drunks and the drug addicts. Hear me, there's a new crop getting ready to come in. There's a new generation getting ready to come out the highways, coming out the hedges, coming out the streets and the lanes. The drunk houses, the whorehouses, the jailhouses, the church houses. Control God.
Yes, sir.
You can't control God.
Hallelujah.
Then you gotta walk on your tiptoes.
Yes, sir.
Follow him.
Yes, sir.
Follow him.
Come on.
Love him with all your heart.
Come on.
I said, follow him. Follow the Lamb. Wheresoever he goeth.
Come on. Jesus.
They feel that just because they say it. God gonna back it up. If it ain't the Bible, he ain't. He'll back up everything in that Bible. But we better watch what we say, expecting God to follow us and back it up. God don't back up no junk. God don't back up false religion. I said, God ain't gonna back up nothing but his word. Because the word is the only thing he is the word. The word was made flesh. Jesus was the word made flesh and walked among us, and we beheld his glory. The glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. That's like this generation. Long just going their way. It's like this old twisted grace message. Got people in a mess.
Yes, it does.
He's on television preaching. I said, this old twisted grace message. Sure, without the grace of God, ain't none of us would be here tonight. But the grace of God don't excuse you to sin. It don't bless you in your sins. The grace of God gives you grace to come back to the altar when you sin and repent. Now these preachers are telling folks, you'll come. But let me tell you, when you receive, you gotta repent. What happened to the 10 foolish virgins?
That's right.
If everybody's just saved, the door was shut. That's what happened. The Bible said there was 10 virgins. 5 was wise, 5 was foolish. They all slumbered and slept. Really, none of them wasn't doing what they should have been doing. They were slumbering and sleeping, but there was virgins that were church folks, that were saved people. Believers,
yes.
Virgins,
go ahead.
Separate from the world.
Yeah.
But at midnight a cry was made, the Bible said. Go ye out to meet him. The bridegroom coming. And you know, when the bridegroom in those days, when the bridegroom was coming, the people would light their lamps and go out and meet the bridegroom to bring him in the house for the marriage. The wives stood up and trimmed the lamps. And went to go out to meet the bridegroom. The foolish said, sell us of your oil. And listen to what he said. For our lamps are gone out. See, the lamps at one time burned.
Come on, preacher.
Just like tonight. And some of you, your lamp one time burned. But tonight it's gone out. You one time was on fire for God. You prophesied. You prayed all night. You read your Bible daily.
Jesus.
You fasted.
Go ahead.
Yes.
Oh, God. Oh, man.
And the wise told the foolish, said, not so, lest we have not enough for ourselves. Go back to them that sell and buy for yourself. They knew what to do, they just hadn't done. It's bad to know what to do and not to do it.
That's right. My God, that's right.
You're responsible when you know what to do. People tell you, well, I know. I just ain't living it. I know I should be praying. I know I should be fasting. I just don't seem like I can fast anymore. Ain't no fast easy. You just have to fast.
That's right.
Just have to get hungry for God.
Yes, you do. Go ahead.
I said, you just have to get hungry for God.
Come on.
So then foolish virgins went back to get oil. And while they were gone to get oil, the wise went into the marriage and the door was shut.
That's right.
The foolish came back and knocked on the door and said, let us in, let us in. The husband man said, I know you. No. It don't sound like they're preaching with this twisted grace.
Go ahead.
It's a lie at the pits of hell.
Yes, it is.
Grace don't excuse you to sin.
No,
grace just don't cover you. When you sin, you've got a conscience.
Yes, you do.
And the Holy Ghost. Let me tell you, when the Holy Ghost comes, you know what the first thing he does? He deals with sin. Some people think the Holy Ghost just makes you shout and talk in tongues. But I'm telling you, when the real Holy Ghost comes, the first thing it does is deal with sin.
My God, go ahead.
The Bible says, for the grace of God has appeared unto all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, that we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. As long as Jesus multiplied the fish and the loaves, they want to make up a king. When he starts saying, I am the bread, said, eat my flesh and drink my blood, the Bible says many of them turned to walk no more.
Jesus.
Many of them, when the word of God began to come pure and simple, they decided, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? The Bible said they turned. they turned and walked no more. They went back. And you say amen.
Amen.
When Jesus therefore perceived that they would come take him by force to make him a king, he departed again to the mountain alone. So they was coming to force him to be a king. But you know what stopped him? Because when he started giving them the word, they decided then, I don't want to follow this man after all. Listen. Jesus answered them and said, "Verily, verily, I say to you, you seek me not because you saw the miracles, but because you did eat of the loaves and were filled. Labor not for the meat which perishes, but for that which endureth forever." Thank you, Jesus. "Unto everlasting life, which the Son of Man shall give you. By him hath God the Father said." Then Jesus said, "Verily, verily, I say to you, Moses gave you not that bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread." Then said they to him, "Forevermore give us this bread." Jesus said, "I'm the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger." I'm just glad of that bread tonight.
Yes, amen.
What Jesus can do for you. "And he that believeth on me shall never thirst. Verse 44. No man can come to me except my Father do. 43, Jesus said, therefore, answered, said to them, "Murmur not among yourselves." Back up here in verse 41, it said, "The Jews then murmured at him because he said, I am the bread which come down from heaven." 42, and he said, "Is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How then can he said, I come down from heaven?" They couldn't understand and didn't know who he was. He said, "Murmur not among yourselves. No man can come except my Father draw it. I will raise it up to the last day." We're on down to verse 66. I mean, you notice what that is. 666. St. John 6 and verse 66. The mark of the beast. And what they said from that time, many of them turned and walked no more with him. 666. We in a day that the spirit of Antichrist, people calling it a great revelation, this twisted grace, but all it is, what it is people turning. But when you walk away from Jesus, you go into the system. You go into the Antichrist. He said in 66, a 666, St. John 6, verse 66. From that time, many of them, many of his disciples, many of his disciples, folks that followed him, men that followed him, from that time, many of his disciples turned and walked no more with him. They went back. You know what Paul said in 2 Thessalonians? He said, because they want the love of the truth, God shall send them strong delusions that believe a lie and be damned. Read to you in Jeremiah where he said, "Flee." You know where it takes it? It's the Antichrist system. It takes people into a place that they're going to receive the mark of the beast and they ain't going to even realize.
Go ahead.
It's going to be a good thing. Do you know in that Obamacare, you've got the chip? 2017, it's in Obamacare, where there's a chip. It wasn't about health care, because you know how health care is tripled. It wasn't about health care. He fooled the people. You know what it was? It's about the mark of the beast. Next year, if God don't stand up and help us and appeal this thing, give us mercy. They got it in Obamacare. Everybody's got to take a chip. Everybody's got to take a chip. And you talk about some severe punishment in the book of 14th chapter of the book of Revelation. He said, it shall call both rich, free bond, free to receive a mark in the palm of the hand before him. That no man might buy, say.
That's right.
That's the word.
Go ahead.
That's the word.
True.
Yes, it is.
Unless they got the mark.
Go ahead, Brother Ray.
When the Bible spoke about the beast, said he had power to overcome and kill the saints. I know that the rapture doctrine says that the church is going to be gone, but how can you kill the saints?
That's right.
Go to heaven and get them?
Go ahead.
Saints are going to be here. We're going to overcome him. The Bible said they overcame him. Talking about the beast, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And the love of their lives unto the dead. If the church is gone, tell you where the rapture doctrine comes from if you want to know. 1835, a young Scottish girl, 12 years old, had a dream. That's where it came from.
Go ahead.
Study that. Ain't Bible.
Go ahead, preacher.
The saints overcome. Great is he that's in you than he that's in the world. We're going to overcome. We're going to overcome. God's going to give us grace to overcome. In 1835, a young Scottish girl had a dream that the church was taken out for tribulation, and Schofield, a lot of them put in their footnotes. That's where it came from. People started adding in their doctrine, became church doctrines. But it ain't scripture.
No, it ain't scripture.
They overcame him. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of the testimony. The church is going to overcome the beast. See, we're not going to take the mark. The real church ain't going to receive the mark. God's going to deliver us. God's going to help us. But all those who receive the mark will be doomed. There'll be no salvation. But see, the thing about it is, if you get that old spirit, you're not even going to know. People think it's a good thing. It's no more than the Social Security. When people turn their back on Jesus like they did, they start going into this Babylonian mystery Babylon, 17th chapter. Look at the book of Revelation. That's why I read that while ago, it said, Jeremiah, my people, go ye out with the midst of her. Deliver ye every man his soul from the anger of the Lord. Babylon's going to fall. The world system's going to fall. The false church is going to fall. There ain't nothing going to be remain standing but the kingdom of God. Everything else is going to collapse. But if you're in Jesus, you'll stand. There ain't nothing going to stand but those in Jesus. Everything else is going to collapse. Hallelujah. Getting in this word, you're going to collapse. One down with the world. But if you're in this book, if you're in this Bible, you'll stand. It'll keep you. The word of God will sustain you. The word of God. 18th chapter. Thank you, Jesus. Revelation chapter 18. I heard another voice, 18 and 4, I heard another voice from heaven said, come out of her, my people. He's talking. You know why they're selling out? They're sold out of the system. Come out of her, my people, he said. Be not partaker of her sins. You won't be a partaker of her plagues. For her sins have reached to heaven, and God hath remembered her iniquities. Look what he said in 17. There came out of the seven angels, one of the seven angels, which had seven vials, and talked with me, saying unto me, come here that I will show thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters. Come, I want to show you the judgment of the great whore. Now this great whore is false religion.
$1,000 seed, and God will bless you.
You better know what you're sowing into.
Amen.
You better know what you're bidding God speak to.
Yes, sir. That's right.
So don't let them in your house and don't bid them God speak.
That's what it says. That's right. That's the word.
That's the word. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So don't let them in your house and don't bid them God speak. Having a golden cup and a handful of the abomination and filthiness of a fornication. She gave him the drink from that cup. The filth of a fornication. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon. Listen. Mystery Babylon, the mother of harlots, an abomination of the earth. And I saw the woman talking with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. That woman, Mr. Babylon, was drunk with the blood of the saints and with the martyrs of the children of God.
That's right.
Let me tell you, false religions kill more than anybody else, Christians.
Go ahead.
False religion, they kill Jesus, they kill our Lord. They delivered up the apostles. Thank you, Jesus. I said, thank you, Jesus. Don't you love him?
Yes,
I
might.
I said, don't you love him?
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
But you're the words you want to stand. As long as Jesus was multiplied in fish and loaves, when he began giving the word, they turned and walked with him no more. They went the other way. Thank you, Jesus. But you know what? It ain't going to stop the kingdom. There's a new crop coming in. God's going to bring in a new crop. God's going to bring in a new crop out of the highway. You can get ready. God's getting ready to bring a new crop in. Out of the highways and the hedges. They're going to come and flood it. Oh, they're going to come so fast. It's going to shock folks. Just like that. You go back and study revival history when God got ready. Just like that, things broke.
Yes.
Things changed.
Hallelujah.
Just like that. Hallelujah. Men went to closets. Men went to cabins. Men climbed up hollow logs. Men climbed up in broad patches and stayed there till God spoke to them. Hallelujah! Just like that, things changed. God raised up a ministry that shook nations. Let me tell you, God ain't crippled. God ain't jammed in the corner. He'd reach out to you tonight. Let me tell you, he don't have to have none of us. He'd reach out to you tonight, some crack at it. Save him, fill him with the Holy Ghost, and tomorrow night at this time, you couldn't get near him. If that's what God wanted to do, I want you to know he's still God. He's God. I'm not worried about it. He's still God. And I'm telling you, he's promised a revival. He's promised a last day outpouring of the Holy Ghost. Do you believe?
Yeah.
I said, do you believe?
Yeah.
But when people, see Paul spoke, he said, we're not of them that draw back unto perdition. See, when you draw back from the truth, people don't realize they go into perdition.
Amen.
When you draw back from the word of God, you go into perdition. Perdition is the kingdom of the Antichrist.
Jesus.
You're deceived. You think you're right.
Go ahead.
You say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Lift your hands up and just love him. Thank you, Jesus. Listen. Hebrews 10, 38. Now just to live by faith. But if any man draw back, my soul hath have no pleasure in him. Next verse says, but will none of them that draw back unto perdition. See, when you draw back from the word of God, you draw back unto perdition.
Yes,
ain't but one, two ways to go. That's for Jesus or with Antichrist.
Right.
There ain't no in between for us. It's either Jesus Christ or Antichrist.
Amen.
Go ahead. And I'm Pentecostal, I'm a Baptist. It's either Jesus Christ or Antichrist. Draw back to perdition. Listen, I'm going to let you. The Lord lets you. I forgot about time. Lord, help us. Turn to Revelation 14. See, this is the final. Thank you, Jesus. Six. And I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven, having an everlasting gospel preached to them that dwell on the earth, to every nation, kingdom, tongue, and people. Saying with a loud voice, fear God, give glory to him, for the hour of judgment is come, and worship him that made heaven and earth, the sea and the fountains of water. And the following another angel said, Babylon is fallen. Is fallen, that great city, because she made all nations drink the wine of the wrath of her fornication. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and the image and receive his mark in the forehead or in his hand, listen to what he said, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture in the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels, in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever. They have no rest day and night, who worship the beast and the image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. You say,
amen.
We're not of them, Paul said, to draw back unto perdition. You draw back from the truth. There ain't one place to go. You're going to perdition. This is where you wind up. Receiving the mark of the beast, not even realizing it's a wrong. Stand on your feet. Lift your hands to the Lord. Oh, God. Help me to love the truth. Lift your hands and God, help me to stay with the Bible. God, help me to stay with the Bible, Lord. I can't afford it. Lord, for people to receive me. I can't sell this Bible out. I can't give up on this word. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Lift your hands up and say, God, I want to stick with your word. I don't want to walk away. Turn my back on the truth. Say, they're turning walk with him no more. St. John 6:6, the mark of the beast. Preachers today have got folks not even thinking about it. We're going to face these times. Don't you let nobody fool you. There ain't going to be no rapture. No church. It ain't Bible. We're going to overcome the beast. We're going to overcome with the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. He said, we love not our lives unto the death. Are you listening tonight? Lift your hands to him and tell him, Lord, I need you. Oh, help me. Oh, it's so easy, folks. You swept off of this old false religion. This old television stuff. It's so easy to be swept away. Swept off your feet. You go into perdition. You draw back from the truth because this other message sounds better to the flesh. Stay with the truth. Stay with Jesus. Stay with Jesus. Follow the Lamb. Follow the Lamb. Follow the Lamb. Oh, Jesus is the only hope. I said, Jesus is the only hope. Prepare to meet thy God. We're in the last days. Jesus is coming. Time is winding up. I said, time is winding up. Go tell some like the old song. Go tell your next door neighbor, time is winding up. Go tell somebody, time is winding up. It's time to get it ready. Get it right. It's time to empty out before God. Say, Lord, I want to be ready. If you call me before daylight, I want to be ready. Lord, if I have to face you before the sun rises, I want to be ready. Don't you let these old false prophets tell you grace discovers you. You lie, cheat, steal, commit adultery. Grace covers you. You got to repent. You got to repent your sins. That's when God covers you with his blood, is when you repent. You got to repent. Got to get it right. Got to get your attitudes right. Got to get your heart right, people. You got to love one another. You can't do, you know Jesus commanded us. We call it sometimes the 11th commandment. Jesus said, a new commandment I give you. That's you love one another as I've loved you. He commanded us. We got to line up with the Bible. We got to line up with the Word. John's message was repent, for the kingdom of heaven's at hand. There's a revival coming. But we've got to get ready for it. We got to empty out. We got to let the Word of God wash us. We got to repent. The kingdom of heaven's at hand. Well, we live in a generation when you think folks have just about got it right, they blow it. Church folks have been in church for life. When you think they just about got it right, they blow it. They come up with some old attitude. It's time to get it right. Lift your hands and say, Lord, I want to get it right. Oh, I just want to get it right, Lord. Come just gather around these altars. Come on, let's get it right. The brothers on my right, the sisters on my left. Come on, let's fall on our knees at this altar. If you feel like you need to pray, if you feel like there's something in you, you feel like there's something you need to get right with God. Get it right. Oh, come on, let's get it right. Come on, let's empty out. Come on, let's empty out. Bible. touch of the mind. Lord, search my heart. Search my mind. Search my soul.
Uphold me with thy free spirit.
Then will I teach transgressors thy ways. Sinners shall be converted unto thee. I want to pray the sinner's prayer. Just pray. Everybody pray with me. Oh God, have mercy upon my soul. Forgive me of my sins. I confess Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I ask you, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. I give my life to you today. I denounce the devil. I denounce sin. I denounce this whole world. I give my life to you, Lord. I believe that the blood of Jesus that was shed at Calvary washes all my sins away. Lord Jesus, from this day forth, I give my life. Use me, Lord, for thy glory from this day forth. In Jesus' name. Let everybody say amen.
Amen.
Lift your hands up and praise. You that wasn't saved, you prayed this prayer with all your heart. You can lift your hands and thank God that your sins is forgiven. Will you lift your hands and tell the Lord, God, thank you for washing in your precious blood. Lord, I thank you. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost. Oh, I know we have a critic now, man. And I ain't concerned about you. I'm concerned about those that won't be saved. Lift your hands up and just thank you. If you already saved, thank you for saving the others. Come on, say, God, I thank you. I thank you for the blood. I thank you for the blood of Jesus. That washes all of my sins away. Thank you, Lord, that one day you saved me. Lord, I thank you one day you forgave me. You thank him all over again. You praise him when he saved you 10 years ago, 20 years ago. Yesterday, tonight, you can give him praise. Oh, hallelujah. Come on and give him praise. I feel the Holy Ghost.
Ah! Just be obedient tonight. God bless you.